So this is one of my favourite things in the museum, and I love them for lots and lots of different reasons. Just to let you know what they are, first, some of you might already know, they're knitting sheaths. Now, I am not a great knitter, but I do think this is a very clever contraption. You would either tuck it into your belt or tie it around with a ribbon nice and tight, and it would hold one needle steady so that you had one hand free to do other tasks around the home or whatever, and you could knit using the other needle. Or sometimes you'd have more than one needle, so for example if you were making socks. So they're different shapes depending on the different regions that they come from, so they're found across the north of England, and it's really, they were found before the onset of the Industrial Revolution, before knitting became very industrialised. So that's just to show you with the needles in, and they come in all different shapes, but what's lovely about them is they are often made as love tokens, so they've often got people's names carved in them. So this is a present for you, Jane Johnson, and it's from John Clark. And if you can see the date, it's 1839, and he's even carved a little face into the top of it. And then they've all got a hole in one end, which is where you'd poke your knitting needle into it. And then this one here might look quite familiar because it is a present for you, Elizabeth Davison, from John Clark of Wickham in 1849. So, oh, and he's added a little heart to this one as well. So I don't know whether these were just friendship gifts or whether he was had a bit of a roving eye, Mr. John Clark, I don't know. These ones here, you can see them, these are interesting because they were all made again by the same person, and we know who it was, and we've got a pop photo of him. His name was Timothy Tarn, and he came from Teesdale, and he made all of these beautiful things using a pocket knife. And so they're super clever because he's carved them all from one single piece of wood, and he's incorporated a chain. This one's got a little picture in it, if you can see, a tiny photograph, and some text as well. "Ye are the salt of the earth," it says. So very beautiful things, and very, very clever. These are lovely. Every object in the museum has a date that of when we brought it into the museum. So you can see here, we got all of these at different points in time, and yet we know, because of the style of them and the design, that they were made by the same person, which was this chap here. And probably, he might have made them for an exhibition, like an agricultural fair, something like that, to show off his skill. Or again, this is my romantic side, maybe he made them for different ladies, who knows.